This is for students that have already begun to learn the anatomy of the brain to give them an opportunity to see, do you know what you think you know? Because a lot of the times what I'm seeing is students are using Quizlets or flashcards and they're always looking at the same pictures. So they think that they know the structure, but what's happening is they don't know what the structure looks like. They know what their flashcard looks like and their Quizlet question looks like. So when you get to your test and it's not your Quizlet or your flashcard, you're lost. So this is an opportunity for you to look at things differently to see, do you know it in a context other than your flashcard or your Quizlet or whatever you've been doing? So I'm going to say, what's this, what's this, what's that? And give you an opportunity to fill in the blank. So this entire region on the outside of your brain is what? This entire region. What is this entire region here? And this, and this. So the whole region on the outside of your brain is the cerebrum. This point that I indicated here on the inside of your brain, the whole thing is the diencephalon. This whole structure, the brainstem, and this entire thing, the cerebellum. Cerebrum, cerebellum. So this whole region is the brainstem, but it has three regions in it. This, this, and this. This is the midbrain, pons, and medulla oblongata. All of the hills are called what? All of the ridges are called what? And all of the valleys are called what? So all of the hills are called gyri. All of the valleys are called sulci. Singular would be gyrus and sulcus. What is the name of this specific sulcus? What is the name of this specific gyrus? What is the name of this specific gyrus? So this is the central sulcus. In front of the central sulcus is the pre-central gyrus. Behind it is the post-central gyrus. What is this? What is this? And then what is the strip of tissue here? The longitudinal fissure separates the halves of your cerebral hemispheres. The transverse fissure separates your cerebrum from your cerebellum. And the vermis is the strip of tissue that's connecting your cerebellar hemispheres. Coming to the inside, what is this, this, and this? This is the corpus callosum. Underneath the corpus callosum is the septum pellucidum. Underneath the septum pellucidum is the fornix. The corpus callosum is a big tract of white matter that's connecting your cerebral hemispheres. The septum pellucidum is a wall that separates your lateral ventricles. Think of the septum in your nose. The septum in your nose is a wall between your nostrils. The septum pellucidum is a wall between your ventricles. And underneath the septum pellucidum is the fornix, which is a tract of white matter within the limbic system. In the beginning, remember we said this whole region was what? The diencephalon. The diencephalon has three regions. What is this region? This region and this pink line region. So this is the hypothalamus. Hypo means below, and it's the hypothalamus because this is the thalamus. And then above the thalamus, this pink line is the epithalamus. So what is this white bump? This brown dot, this pink dot, and these white bumps back there. This is the mammillary body. To me, the diencephalon plus the brainstem looks like a seahorse. The mammillary body would be the double chin of the seahorse, because if you just think, oh, it's a white bump, there are lots of white bumps on the brain. It's specifically this white double chin of the seahorse. This brown dot is the intermediate mass. The intermediate mass connects the two halves of the thalamus. At the end of the epithalamus, that pink dot is the pineal gland. And these two bumps, which are on the back of the midbrain, are the corpora quadrigemina. So there's two on this half of the brain. The other two are on the other half of the brain, so there are four total. What are they if we're just talking about the two on the top or the two on the bottom? Just talking about the two on the top would be the superior colliculi, and the two on the bottom are the inferior colliculi. So what did we say this was again? The septum pellucidum. And remember, that's the wall between your ventricles. Now looking at the other half of the brain model, what's this? It's not the septum pellucidum because it's not a wall. The septum pellucidum is removed on this side of the model. The empty space you're seeing behind it is the lateral ventricle. Remember, ventricles are those empty spaces in your brain that contain your cerebrospinal fluid. If we take this apart, you can see the lateral ventricle better. It's just the empty wishbone shape space. So the fluid from your lateral ventricle doesn't stay there. It's gonna go through this hole. What is this hole? What is this empty space? This empty space, and this empty space. This hole is called the interventricular foramen because it's connecting your lateral ventricle to this, which is the third ventricle. The region is the diencephalon, but the empty space within the diencephalon is the third ventricle. Coming into here, this is the cerebral aqueduct, and this is the fourth ventricle. So what did we say this region was again? The pons. And we haven't mentioned this thick band of tissue or this thick band of tissue. This is the cerebral peduncle. It is a tract of white matter that's connecting the pons and the cerebrum. So this is the cerebral peduncle. This thick tract of tissue is the middle cerebellar peduncle because it's connecting the pons to the cerebellum. There are more cerebellar peduncles, but we can only see this one on this model. So the chest of the seahorse was the pons. What is the tail of the seahorse? The medulla oblongata. And what is this thick lump on the front of the medulla oblongata? And what is this pink dot here? This lump is the pyramid, and the pink dot is the olive. So when we popped off the top, the empty space was the lateral ventricle, but there's other stuff in there. What is this? This. And what's that? So up at the top is the caudate nucleus. On the bottom is the hippocampus. I don't know if I pointed to this, but what is that? That is the fornix. Remember, you see the fornix on the outside? Well, some of it's coming to wrap around to the inside because it's a white matter tract in the limbic system. And this is the internal capsule. All right, so keep in mind, I did not mention every single thing on this brain. There are other models to look at. There are other angles. If you really struggled with this and could not answer anything, that should tell you that you need to change up your studying. Also, remember, watching my video over and over again to the point where you can recite it is just as bad as looking at the same flashcards all the time, because then you're not learning it, you're just learning my video, which won't help you on your test. So find different pictures. Ideally, find a study partner. A lot of people are still learning virtually, but if you and a study partner have your own pictures and quiz each other, that will help a lot. It helps you to quiz somebody because you have to think about it, and it helps you to be quizzed because it's kind of keeping you on your toes. So I hope you all have a great day, and really feel free to reach out to me if you are just having a hard time figuring out why your studying isn't going so well.